Recently, Airtable has flown under the radar with some massive quality of life improvements. They've made some really cool updates to the platform, and I haven't heard anybody talking about it. Well, I'm gonna break it down for you in this video, showing you exactly what has changed for the better and telling you why it matters. So, if learning more about the quality of life updates in Airtable is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of Airtable and the related no-code tools in this industry. Now, before I get into the heart of things, I want to first invite you to join me for some training. I've put together an Airtable crash course. You can access it completely free, and we will send to you our bite-sized trainings so that you can master the key building blocks of Airtable. Sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and we will drop that in your inbox so that you can start leveraging the true power of this incredible software. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and I'm going to show you these quality of life improvements. Now, the first couple might not seem like that big of a deal, but let me tell you that they are, from my perspective, things I've been wishing Airtable did for years, and it's just now done it. And the funniest part is they did it without any fanfare at all. The first of these has to do with the names of the fields. So I'm at the data layer in Airtable, and very often we'll put together a longer field name. Like, you know, here we have full name, last name, first name. And the issue is when we wanted to like make these really small, then we got this dot, dot, dot up at the top. We had no idea what the naming field was unless we moused over it like this and it popped up and said, ah, this is actually first name. And so this was a real bummer, right? So we had to keep our fields kind of longer than we necessarily wanted them. And it just kind of felt weird, right? But here's the new quality of life improvement. We can shrink this down and then elongate our headers up here for our fields, which allows us to see the full name. So now we don't have to have these long fields just to display the name of the field. We can shrink them down, double stack, triple stack, gosh, quadruple stack, because we can make the field names as tall as we would like. And they will wrap for us just as you see here. It's just gonna wrap, and we just like that can now see our fields much more clearly. Now, again, this is not a humongous thing. It's not gonna change the way that you use Airtable, except for the fact that it means you'll be able to get more on your screen at once, and you can still read your field names perfectly clearly. So I really love this. Again, it was a small change, but one that was a long time coming. Now, for another small quality of life change, but again, one that I think has a big impact. A lot of times you'll start building in Airtable, as I've done here, and then maybe you get a few fields in and you think, ah, I really wish I had a different field in the primary field. See, I put here the first name, the last name, and the full name, but maybe I wish that my full name was on the far left, and that's how I identified these records. Because if I have another record here, let's say I've got a John Stranger, well then, how do I know which of these is the right John, especially if I'm linking to other stuff? So imagine a scenario here where I've got a table for, like, let's say tasks, and we want to link to table one. When I do this and I go to find John, well, I see John here and I see John here, and I might want to just be able to like do a quick search for stranger and then pull up the right John. Well, that doesn't work that way because of the way I named my primary fields. So flip back over here to table one. I can only search by whatever you find right here. So if I'm looking to link this to a record, I have to type John and then look at the records and make sure that I find the one that I'm looking for. So what if you wanted to change this and, let's say, I don't know, make the full name the primary field? Well, as of a couple months ago, that was a really tall order. You had to delete this field, move this field over, create a new field, make this a formula. It was a whole ordeal. But now it's as simple as clicking and dragging and dropping. So I'm gonna click my full name field here and just drag it all the way over to the far left. And just like that, when I let it go, you see that I can now change the primary field so easily. So I just bumped it over, right? It honestly, this again, this isn't a huge thing. You'd think that maybe Airtable would have done this a long time ago, frankly, but I'm sure there was probably a lot under the hood, in fact, that they had to figure out. Because I have to imagine that the way that you name your records has a lot to do with the underlying architecture of Airtable. But now they've solved it. Now we can do this. And so if I want to link to John Stranger from my second table, all I had to do was reorder my primary field. And now I can click and I can start typing Stranger. And just like that, I find him in the list. So this is a huge quality of life update. I'm really excited that we can now change our primary fields so easily. And it's no longer this long, arduous workaround. Now for the third new thing that I've noticed Airtable released, it's actually, I'm gonna go to a different element entirely. I'm gonna look at our actual Gap Consulting video content here. We can now generate AI images. I'm gonna actually run this agent, and while I'm talking, we're gonna see it generate an AI image. So let's take a look at this new field agent. This is an AI generated image. Notice here that we have the option of selecting the image type. This was not available to us previously because it used to be that when we created a field agent, it was text-based. But now we can create that image. We can set it to run automatically. We can also input the image fidelity. So this is going to preserve things, especially if we're using faces or logos. We don't want AI to run amok with that information, so we would set it to high. We also want to bring in some output options. So right now you can see I've set mine to auto, but in this case we might be building a YouTube thumbnail, for example. So we can tell it what type of format we want to use, what size we're looking for, and then what the quality is. So we can choose if we want to make it higher or lower. Now bear in mind that the higher the quality, the higher the image size, of course this is going to use more AI credits. So be thoughtful about how you are burning these things. And then of course we can also bring in the field, or the file name. So we can choose how we want to name this. And if we don't put anything here, then it's just going to auto-generate. So those are our options. We only have the one model to select from here for image creation. And just as you would any other component or any other field agent in Airtable, we can write out a prompt and include information from other parts of this record. So I'm bringing in the video title here, as well as the featured partner, which in this case is Airtable. And then of course we're saying, hey, the format we want to dump out is in files, but we could also use the versions copy if we wanted to do that. Versions is another way of looking at files where we can iterate the different assets, the different files that we've added, and see them side by side. So let's go ahead and save that up. And we're just in time now to pop out and see the YouTube thing that was generated here. So this is a sample image that we could use. You can see that I put in the text, set it and forget it. And well, AI, still not quite perfect, especially when it comes to text. So you might choose to not use text in your images at all, because this was information that I passed to it, as well as the name of this video. So Airtable Automation's Deep Dive Beyond the Basics. That part seemed to come in just fine, which I like. So that was great. And I should also highlight that it did a good job of creating a little bit of a, you know, Airtable vibe here. I have no idea. I don't know if you can even read this in the video, but it says trees, T-R-E-A-S. So that part's probably not great. We should definitely give our AI further instruction about not using more text, because it gets it wrong a lot of the time. But overall, this is a pretty cool feature as well. So that's it for this video. Three things that are going to make our lives a little bit easier, especially as we're building in Airtable and linking our tables and changing those primary fields just more easily and seeing those field names double or triple stacked up on the headers. I know we went quickly in this video. Of course, if you have questions that I did not address here, please swing by our website because we've put a ton of resources together for you there for you to check out so you can get the answers you need. Of course, if you did enjoy this, we'd love a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. But the most important thing, my friends, keep on building.